Let us pledge together to protect the health of our planet Earth. Let us pledge together to protect all living beings of the planet. Let us spend 30 minutes time to discuss and debate the Vriksha Ayurveda scope and further future prospects in the R&D sector, including various other disciplines, agriculture and horticulture, etc. Vriksha Ayurveda is the art of maintaining the health and healing and productivity of plants. It is a scientifically unexplored topic, which is a part of the healing art of India, exclusively practiced by the ancient scholars of Ayurveda, adopting purely an organic approach in different sectors like agriculture, medicinal plant culture, and horticulture. Vriksha Ayurveda emphasized the importance of Chitrikaranam, that is the ancient biotechnological intervention and research, with a view to explore the commercial aspect of the plant world. Vriksha Ayurveda is specifically meant for the conservation, propagation, cultivation, plant care, and development of plant-based processes and products, including manures, organic liquid manures, biopesticides, growth regulators, and promoters, and that are effectively utilized for the healthy germination, nourishment, rejuvenation, and treatment of plants. You see, now I am coming to some scientific aspects of Vriksha Ayurveda. Because before that, I think when we look into the historical perspective, actually everything started from the oral tradition. Oral tradition means somewhat before 3000 BC. After that, it started the Vriksha Ayurvedic documentation, started from Vedic literature, then Upanishads, and then Puranic literature, epic literature, Samhita period, Buddhist literature, Kaudilya Arthashastra, so on, and then come up to the Suryapala's Vriksha Ayurveda. He is the first person to compile the Vriksha Ayurveda, actually. Then later, after the independence, there are a number of Indian authors. They have translated this Suryapala's Vriksha Ayurveda, as well as Vriksha Ayurveda, Sharangatara Pathadi of Vriksha Ayurveda, and some Malayalam publication is also there. But as a scientist, Nene Vaiyal, he's a pathologist actually. He did excellent work on, research work on, this Vriksha Ayurveda. Then finally, of course, Kerala Biodiversity Board, they published a book on Vriksha Ayurveda. Of course, author is myself and my colleague, Dr. E.S. Unnikrishnan. Then, of course, I am not going to say much about the topic. There are 14 chapters. Right from the Bhumi Nirupanam, identification and classification of soil and soil conservation techniques. And of course, the last, the ancient biotechnological intervention. That is, that these are all the about the chapters, because there are more eminent personalities are coming, so I don't want to say much about that side. But coming to the scientific input of some of the author of this researchers, because if when you will see the Vriksha Ayurveda, apart from the plant species, because there are I think more than 212 medicinal plants are mentioned in Vriksha Ayurveda. Apart from that, there are 37 animal and animal products are mentioned. But I think this is only a documentation of the ancient time. But the new era, I think we can do lot of studies on this different aspects of Vriksha Ayurveda. Apart from these medicinal plants, if you will see the other base materials they use, the including milk and ghee have been used for centuries. Glutamate, leucine, proline, from about 40% of the total amino acids in the milk. The amino acid proline has been found to systematically induce the resistance of the plant. So that is why they applied other medicines with the milk and ghee. High amounts of endogenous proline increase contents of cytokinin and auxins, which promote vegetative and reproductive growth of the crops. These are all the scientific side, I think it is, I am explaining now. Then lactobacillus bacteria in milk could enhance. Milk could enhance decomposition of organic matter and increase the absorption of nutrient by plants. This bacterium also has the potency to inhibit the attack of wilt disease, especially the experimental studies carried out on tomato. And now, the scientific input on Kunnapajala. You know the Kunnapajala is one of the important polyherbal formulation in the form of bioliquid manure. So this has been designed years back. Therefore, we have to conduct an in-depth study on this, and we can develop number of new protocol and also number of new products based on Kunnapajala. The Kunnapajala, the ingredients, the total ingredients of Kunnapajala have been fermented. It means protein, fat, already broken down to simple molecular weight products, and therefore nutrient from which would become available to plants faster than the traditionally applied organic matter. This is on scientific study of Neff et al. 2009. Recent studies carried out by the scientists of the University of Lancaster and Britain Institute of Green and Environment Research Professor Richard and his team have found not only can organic nitrogen be directly taken up, but also it used differently by different species, enabling the nitrogen sharing. So this is the another observation. Then coming to the potential linkages of Vriksha Ayurveda in agriculture for future application. I am giving some few points on this particular aspects, because there is not much time with me to explain each and every point. Otherwise, each and every points I have to explain. Number one is the utilization of Vriksha Ayurvedic preparation in the commercial agriculture. You see, whatever the things they have done there, even directly or indirectly, there is a part they have already mentioned. They have already mentioned for the commercial agriculture. The fruits and vegetables cultivated using these preparations, apart from being organic, will contain therapeutic compounds. There are secondary metabolites. You see, generally the primary metabolites, as well as we are using as when you are going to treat the plants, then the secondary metabolites are acting. And if you want to have some sort of rejuvenation and immuno enhancing and all, most of those preparations, I think it is based on the primary metabolites. So they can be, so like that, after the research, if you are developing a new product, I think anyone can be branded as Vriksha Ayurvedic food, Vedic food, and marketed in India and abroad. But the scientific validation, it is very important. And also the experimental trial in the field, it is also important. And it will fetch higher price than organic products. Vedic gardens can be designed and established in the heritage site, temples, education, and IT parks, etc., utilizing the garden technique in Vriksha Ayurveda. So in this context, I would like to say that there is a concept of Vriksha Ayurveda Park, actually. Actually, this, I think they have mentioned, they have the design of that park. I think it is called Sarvadobhadram. Sarvadobhadram means it's a square plot with the four doors, east, west, and north, south, and the end, that central portion, I think there is a pond. Then around the pond, you have to plant trees like this. Ashwathamekam, Pichumandamekam, Nagrodamekam, Dasatindranija, Kapitta, Villu Amalagatrayanja, Panchambravabi, Naragam Navashye. It's very, very interesting. And it is scientifically designed, this garden, park, garden or park, you can say. And for in this one Ashwadha, that you know that Ficus religiosa, one Pichumanda, vapor, Sadrikta indica, and Nagrodham peral, and another one is 10 plants of this, I think it is called
Puli.
Yeah, tamarindus indicus, and in that you can select, you can modify it. All, if it is all tamarind, 10 tamarind plants means some problem in the ecosystem. So that is why 5 you can take Garcinia, 5 you can take this tamarind. And then there are 3 trees, as 3 each. One is Kapitta. Kapitta, there is a plant species. Nowadays, I think it is not very common. Limonium acidismus actually. And Amalagam, that you know, these are all 3 each. And then Panchambra, the mango tree, that you have to plant 5. Panchambravapi, Naragam Navashyati. Why? All these plants are having the high carbon sequestration potential plant species. So it's produced the oxygen profusely and also absorb the carbon dioxide in other side. So this kind of a park, I think we can implement definitely wherever the suitable land is available, and also a demonstration garden. And also the park means anybody can come and sit and enjoy, and what are the plants here and what are the medicinal properties of these plants. These are all the things you can exhibit there. And the next part is the utilization of organic waste, like chicken meat. Nowadays there is a lot of meat waste. So that you can effectively utilize for the preparation of Kunabadala. Now the North India, they are having organic then vegetable punabadala. This is actually it is a non-vegetarian punabadala. It is already mentioned in Ayurvedic, Riksha Ayurvedic literature. So they, those the Rajasthan people, I just went once Udaipur University. There was a conference, so they invited me to for a keynote address. So they are having their own punabadala. They have that. That is why I said. And another thing is, you see how you are going to treat a human being the same way. That is the fundamental principle. The same way you have to treat the plants also, whether it is preventive aspect or whether it is promotional aspect, whether it is corrective aspects or whether it is curative aspect. Another point here is the inclusion of Riksha Ayurvedic knowledge. Knowledge in the syllabus of graduation in agriculture, biotechnology, microbiology courses, so that in other discipline also they should get information on this. Of course, in Ayurveda, all the MD Revya Guna departments, and they have to take care of this shastra, and they are the specialists to move forward. And how we can design new protocol, how we can conduct a multidisciplinary kind of research, and how we can develop process, how we can develop products, then the technology, how the technology can be transferred. And also, after that, you can go for a commercialization. Even the startup group, if there is a few younger people from the Ayurvedic side, definitely they can take this challenge. And another one is to explore the possibility of incorporating the Riksha Ayurvedic preparation and technology in the prevailing farming system. It's very, very important. And bring out a harmonious blend of Riksha Ayurveda with the traditional animal husbandry practices. So you can again blend with Ayurveda, Riksha Ayurveda, Mruga Ayurveda, Astya. So you can again, you can have a kind of integration, including the fisheries, to establish a Riksha Ayurvedic demonstration plot and gardens. And the next is the establishment of Riksha Ayurvedic consultation centers in the district level, which will be functioning as a consultation come extension center for the farmers regarding the Riksha Ayurvedic techniques. Establishment of Riksha Ayurvedic production come eco shops at district level, which will be a standardized Riksha Ayurvedic products inputs, and Riksha Ayurvedic manuals, Riksha Ayurvedic pesticide that I have already told you, growth stimulant, flower inducers, enriched soil suitable. You can sell the soil. You can enrich the soil. You can enrich the medicated soil. And you can even specific soil for specific plant species. But here all we need a kind of multidisciplinary research that is more and more important. Next is the establishment, this is the diagnostic protocol of endogenous and exogenous disorders that I have told you as per the fundamental principle of Ayurveda. Then the treatment protocols, based on Tridosha theory and pentavalent basic principle, and diverse scientifically validated products including micronutrients, biomanuals, liquid biomanuals, immunoenhancers, stamina boosters, growth promoters, growth regulators, biopesticide, tonic, fumigators, fumigator, that is also a product you can develop, and medicinal products are treatment for diseases. That is for treating diseases, there is a separate product. And now we are coming to Riksha Ayurveda for conducting multidisciplinary R&D program. So the soil enriched with the nutrients, micronutrients and aroma by adding various plant and animal products, and modification and standardization of punabadala and other liquid manual. You can develop like a punabadala, number of bio liquid manuals you can develop. And even formulation of novel Riksha Ayurvedic products, single and as well as polyherbal formulations, and new products for experimental trials based on Riksha Ayurvedic products. Then new products for experimental cultivation, that is another important area. Cultivation with the new cultivation with the view to develop agrotechnology of plant species according to the WHO guideline by adopting Vriksha Ayurvedic approach and diverse probiotic products and enriching the population of beneficial of microbes in the soil and nutraceuticals providing balanced nutrition and treatment of disease and resistance of the plants. Next. And another one is the medicated self-generated alcoholic preparation treating various plant species and various Vriksha Ayurvedic products for enhancing flowering, fruiting, color enhancement and quality improvement of the fruits. New protocol for awareness, conservation, program based on Vriksha Ayurvedic concept, integrated agrotechnology based on Vriksha Ayurvedic approach. Again, the study of farm-friendly microbes in Vriksha Ayurvedic preparations, study of anti-pathogenic activity of Vriksha Ayurvedic preparation and their mode of action, and study of pesticide properties of Vriksha Ayurvedic preparation and their mode of action, identification of the bacteria responsible for the nutraceutical therapeutic activities of Vriksha Ayurvedic products. Then again, the develop suitable alternatives for certain ingredients in Vriksha Ayurvedic products which are either inaccessible or unavailable. There are many plants and animal products. I think we have to identify. There are some confusion in the taxonomy of some plants and animal products. That can be, I think, ruled out. No problem. And study on the improvement of structure, nutrient content and microbial activity of soil after the application of Vriksha Ayurvedic products, and study on plants' geographical features described as an indicators of availability of the present groundwater. It's an interesting thing, but I think we have to have a proper scientific study on this. Then preparation of database on Vriksha Ayurveda, that is most important. Establishment of school of Vriksha Ayurveda for conducting institutional collaborative research at national and international level. And of course, and I think the time, 5 more minutes it is there. Of course, finally, the Vriksha Ayurveda contains a treasure trove of practical knowledge for organic farmers to produce, save, found in the purest supreme form. But I think I will explain some important prescriptions mentioned in this Vriksha Ayurveda, and it is very interesting and it is very simple also. I think some pre-treatment, you see, pre and post treatment of prescription recommended for seeds. Pre and post treatment of seeds are essentially required to check infection, pest attacks, diseases occur due to climate changes, atmosphere pollution, and nutritional deficiencies. There are more than 25 useful prescriptions mentioned in Vriksha Ayurveda to induce quick termination. For example, you can take another good example is properly dried seeds are soaked in milk and dried again. This is the process actually. So here you can go, if you will do some scientific work, you can go for process patents, as well as when you develop a scientifically validated product, you can go for a patent products. And this process is repeated for 5 days and fumigated with the Empilia rice powder along with the ghee. I have already described clarified butter. Actually, this is from Sharangadhara Pathadi. That is another very, very important textbook of Vriksha Ayurveda. You know, Vayamba, Vaja, Acurus calamus. It's a very simple thing. This can be used as a fungicide to prevent fungal attack. And like that, there are number of very, very important prescriptions. Suppose paddy straw, you see, it is also very, very important. Paddy straw is prepared in the form of rope. You have to prepare a rope and tied over the branches of the Artocarpus Etrophilus chakka, panasam, followed by pouring of the decoction prepared from vaja. So that will profuse, that will help in the jackfruit profuse flowering and fruit. So anybody can try this. Then you have to see how, where the mechanism of action of this this particular application. That is important. And also here you can do lot of field level study without much expense. I think anybody can, any farmer can do it, any Ayurvedic. Of course the Ayurvedic masters, especially the Dravya Guna specialists, so they should look at all these things. And even one, this Artocarpus, this is one thesis, and another prescription, another thesis. So there are number of prescription like this, and it is very, very important. Then fumigation is another added the attraction of Riksha Ayurveda, number of products, and it is for fumigation purpose. Fumigate with the Trifala powder. You know what is Trifala, need not to explain. And below the branches of the fruits of Dadima, Punica, Prenatum, to increase the fruit size. We don't know how Trifala is acting like this. How? That means there are a multi-dimensional mechanism of action. This we have to study. If there is a Punica granatum, you have a Trifala, then do the research and go for a PhD or further that you can take. And of course, there are many biopesticide and all it is mentioned. And simple aromatic soil is prepared. You see, they are, it is very clearly mentioned that the soil, you take fertile soil and mix it with the aromatic flowers. So here, that period, they said flowers, but this period you can put extract or in fraction form, any form, you can apply it, the basin of the tree. And this is followed by pouring of aromatic decoction prepared from, there is a dhava, it is called Anoes datifolia and Kadira. So these are all the preparation. Then paste prepared from the boiled tuberous root of Vitari Kanda, you know, Ipomia mauritiana, in sugar cane juice and smeared over the bottom of the tree. The sugar cane juice is poured on the basin. So this is for fruiting, flowering profusely, irrespective of the season. So if you want this particular product, then you have to do like this. But these are all only clue, as well as this may be an experimental trial. After that, they might have written all this information. Then paste prepared from tila. Tila, you know, the sisamum indicum, vidanga membelia ripes, gomaya cow dung, is mixed with the sugar cane juice and integrated at the bottom of the irrigated at the basin of the trees, again flowering for profusely irrespective of season. Okay. So I think that the time is over, and I would like to conclude this with the message that I think the new generation of Vriksha, the Dravya Guna department, as well as the young generation of the PG students, and those who are doing doctoral and postdoctoral fellowships, definitely they should take up each and every prescription of this and scientifically validate, and you yourself think and you make new formula, single and polyferable formulation, and go for the trial, even the field level trial, it is much. So best wishes for the new young generation. So you should definitely look into and come out with n number of products, so that can be sold nationally and internationally and generate income. So that income again you can utilize for the development of Vriksha Ayurveda. Thank you so much.